In this video, I will talk about Feather 3D, which is an app on the Apple Store for drawing in 3D. This is kinda a mix between Procreate, where you can draw on a 2D canvas, and Shaper 3D, where you can make a 3D model. Here in Feather, you have a 3D canvas where you can draw and view in 3D. Hey friends, welcome back. I'm Noor, I'm an architect and illustrator, and on this channel, we talk about sketching, software, digital art, architectural design, and so much more. Be sure to subscribe if you don't want to miss anything. So here is how Feather 3D works. You need first to draw a 3D guide, because without a guide you can't draw a stroke. For example, the first line I draw is the 3D guide, and this is how it looks when I turn around. Then I can only draw on this guide. If I trace an arc, I am going to have an arc-shaped plane. And if I make a square, I'm going to have a long box like that. This is the most important thing you need to understand about this app. I will quickly show you the basics and some 3D illustrations idea that can be done with this app. When you first open the app, you will see the dashboard where all your drawings are stored. To create a new canvas, tap on the plus icon right down on your screen. This is how your screen will look with your canvas open. On the left, you can find your brushes. There are two types, one which has a pointy tip and the other a square tip. Then you can change the color here. Also the brush size and opacity. On the top right, you can find the draw icon, which is a pencil. If you tap on it a second time, this will allow you to draw neatly, you know, straight lines, circles, and curves. This button right here is for bending a guide. If I draw this circular guide and tap on the bend tool, the starting point of the circle becomes the baseline right here. So when I trace a second line, like this, this will actually be the baseline of the guide. For example, if I want to draw a sphere, first I draw a circle as a guide, then bend it from the top in a circle. Then I have a sphere. So, to continue with the top right buttons, you have then an eraser tool. We have two options, to erase by points or by strokes. Then you have the select and mirror tools here. But I believe that can be a video on its own, so let me know if you are interested to know more about it. Here's the clipboard, which helps you bring an image in a window that can be used as a reference, for example. And finally, you have the group and environment settings. What we call group here is actually the layers. You can also add a fog effect, a grid or background color and image. So here is some illustration examples you can do on Feather 3D. I'm going to first draw a quick floor plan of a house. This is simple for now, as I drew it in 2D. Now let's draw the walls. I like to do each part on new layers so I can hide them anytime I want. Now the roof. Some plants. I also want to add an environment so it doesn't look like it's floating. Some people. I also want to try making some concept diagrams and the interior too on another layer. So that's the final results. I have now multiple layers with the floor plan, the exterior walls, the roof, the diagram, and the interior. This is amazing to present some ideas to clients. So I believe Feather 3D is a game-changing app which has a lot of potential. Sure, there are some things that can get better, like the precision of the brushes and eraser. Maybe they can add more brushes or more settings to the layers. I'm sure this is going to be so useful to a lot of people around the world, so it's really interesting to try. And you know what? I think this is an intuitive app, despite the fact that sketching in 3D is supposed to be a more complex thing. So let me know what you think about it, and if you have any questions, feel free to write to me. I always answer, and see you in the next video.